Hello, everybody. I hope you're having a wonderful day. My name is Corbin from Zoco Marketing. In today's video, we are talking about everything Google Display Ads. I'm going to talk to you about how to, first of all, what a Google Display Ad is really quickly. And then we're going to talk about how to set up your first Google Display Ad, common settings that you can do inside of there. And then at the end, I'm going to talk about how to actually run different optimizations to improve the performance of your ad. So make sure to stay tuned all the way to the end to get the highest performing display ads that you possibly can. So I'm going to jump right in. But before I do want to remind you, please don't forget to subscribe if this is your first time on the channel. And also, please don't forget to like the video if you found value in it today. So we're going to jump in on what a Google Display Ad is. So very quickly. As you can see here, I'm on a blog. On this right-hand side, you see there's this little ad for Vrbo. And then up here, there's this one for Clixies. Those are display ads. They show up on blogs or websites or different things. And there's different ways that you can target these ads. One of the most common ways is for prospecting, so hitting certain audiences that might be interested in your product. And I'm gonna show you how to do that targeting. And then also another common way is for remarketing. So hitting people who have come to your website but not purchased or filled out a form, whatever it may be, showing them banner ads to remind them of your site. So banner display ads can be very useful for those different purposes. And I'm gonna show you how to do that right now. So we're inside of Google Ads, and I'm assuming that you already have a Google Ads account if you're on this video. And the first thing that we're gonna do is come over here to this little plus button. We're gonna hit new campaign. We're going to let this load up, and there are a lot of different objectives that you can do for display ads, but for this purpose, we're going to do website traffic. For most people, website traffic or sales and leads are what I recommend. If you have conversion tracking set up, do sales and leads. If you don't, then do website traffic. Next is we have all these different options. Of course, we want to hit the display to actually run display ads. Now, it's going to present you with three different options. Standard display is where you as the advertiser have the most control. This is where you can choose your targeting, your bidding, and all the different settings inside of here. 99% of the time, this is what I go with, is standard display campaigns. Smart display campaigns is using Google's smart algorithm to actually pick all the optimizations such as bidding and targeting for you. I have seen it where Google just tends to take people's money and run with whatever they can. So I like to have more control and not give it to Google. So I go with the standard display campaign. And then the third one here is Gmail campaigns, which are those ads that show up inside of a user's Gmail. So very straightforward in there. Most of the time, though, you're going to want to go with standard display campaigns. Optional, you can add your website inside of here if you'd like. So we can go https://www.zocomarketing.com. And then we're going to hit continue. We're going to wait for a second for this to load up. All right. And now we are getting into kind of the meat of a display campaign. So the first thing is you're going to want to name this, your campaign name. Typically, if it's like the product or service, so say that we are running this for PPC. So I run PPC for people. So PPC display campaign is what I would call this. So, and give it whatever name will help you realize what you're running inside of here. So next is locations. You can target all countries, United States, in Canada, or enter a specific location. If you only wanted to target like a certain state, like Arizona or New York or Florida, you could go through, or anywhere outside of the United States, you could go through and hit add another location and type that in right here inside of the bar. So say we wanted Arizona, we could type that in and target Arizona specifically, or say we wanted to exclude whatever reason Arizona inside of here, we could do that as well. Now, one setting that is important to note is if you come down here to this location options, Google sometimes gets you to spend more money than you need to. And that's why you're watching this tutorial, because I want to save you money. So the first thing is right here, this location options, you notice how they kind of have it hidden. When you're in the targeting, the default is to target people who are in or regularly or show interest in your target location. So say you want to only target in the United States, and people are Googling for things that show they're interested in the United States, but they're not in the United States, then Google is gonna show your ads to those people. So typically I like to then go through and click this button. So it's only people who are regularly in the United States or in my target location. So, or in the United States and Canada in this case, because I'm targeting there. So an important setting to check inside of here, and then you can leave this inside of the people in your excluded locations. Now, next we have languages, which is pretty straightforward. Just go through and select the languages that you want to target for your audiences. And then right here is bidding. And another bidding can sometimes be, there's lots of different bidding strategies and things that you can do inside of here. as you see, Google asks you what you want to focus on. I'm not going to get too much into bidding, but I want you to kind of know the basics for this tutorial. Now, you can optimize either for conversions or other options. I don't have conversion tracking set up for this demo account, or else I could do these other options, or viewable impressions. So if you want more brand awareness and you want just people seeing your banner ads everywhere, you're going to want to go for this viewable impressions. But if you want to actually get a sale or a lead or people clicking on your ads and going to your website, then you're going to want to choose this conversion. So for this setup, I'm going to do conversions. And then there are, you can manually set your bids or you can automatically maximize your conversions. I typically, when I'm running a brand new campaign, I go for manually setting bids. And this gives me just a little bit more control on what I want to pay for my actual ads. Now, you could also come through if you don't have any idea or you don't want to manage your bids, you want it to be more automatic, then you could do automatically max for conversions. But it is totally up to you on where you want to go from there. Now, as you'll notice, the next thing that it asks is, or you can select bidding strategy directly, and there's all these different things, but I'm not going to get into this right now. But for now, that's what we're going to talk about for bidding, not to just trip people up a little bit here. So the next thing is this budget. So it's going to ask for your average daily budget. Typically for a display campaign, I'll spend anywhere from, you know, $10 to $50. So for this one, we'll just say $20. And as I put this in, you'll notice in this right-hand side, we're going to see this bar start to load. And it's going to give you an idea of how much traffic you can drive with that kind of budget. So as you can see, I'm going to move myself over down here just slightly. There's up to 100 billion impressions, because right now we don't have any targeting. We haven't limited anything. It's basically targeting anybody on Google. And we can get around 170 to 420 clicks at an average cost per click of 27 to 65 cents. So as you can see, these are very cheap clicks that you can drive to your website. Sometimes it's not the highest quality of traffic, but it's a very kind of cheap way to go about driving traffic to your website. And you can see the impressions here and the click-through rate. Now, this, pay attention to these metrics, because these are going to change. I'm actually moving myself up here. These are going to change as we add more targeting, which is the next step that we're getting into. So we've set our budget, we've got our bidding, and you can come in here to additional settings. And there's some other things that you can do inside of here. I'm not going to get too much into these, but because they're pretty straightforward. But you can change your ad schedule to certain times of the day. You can set start and end dates. You can show you can choose the devices that you want to show on. Campaign URL options. These are if you want to add what's called UTM tracking parameters. I'm not going to get into that in this video. And then dynamic ads. This is more for e-commerce. If you have a data feed, more high level or more advanced feature. And then you have conversion actions and content exclusions inside of here. Once again, I'm not going to go too deep into those options for the purpose of this tutorial. Now, the next thing is we have the ad group, and best practice is to name your ad group to describe your targeting or the targeting that you're going for inside here. And you'll kind of get an idea of what I mean once we kind of jump into this. Now, if you want, I'm going to be covering the targeting options, but if you want a more in-depth tutorial on all the different targeting options that you can do inside of Google and YouTube and all the different platforms, you can check out the link below. I go through and walk through all of these different audiences in very big detail, but I'm going to give you a high level overview right here, right now. So Google has all of these different audiences, and as you can come in here, there's a ton, right? So if you come into browse, it kind of breaks it out into detailed demographics. So we can say, okay, let's target people who are parents of these different things. Say you had a product that was for infants or babies or different things. You could target by marital status, education, and homeowner status. So lots of useful things for it depending on what your niche is. And if you come in here, there's also what's called infinity audiences. And these are people who have shown interest in certain products or services. So if we come in here, you can get an idea of some of the products or services that go along in the affinity categories. And then next we have in-market events, which are people who are actively searching for a product or service. So say that I am a company that is looking for a specific software right now. I could come in here and we can go to in-market audiences and then maybe go down to business services. And for me, because I want to target people who are looking to run PPC, maybe I come into advertising marketing services, and I could target people who are actively looking inside of Google for SEO and SEM marketing services and run my display ads to those people. So a very powerful audience. And as you can see, as I've added these, it's now adjusting my clicks and my click-through rate and then my average impressions inside of here. It's actually hasn't adjusted it just yet, but it will once we kind of get through in here. So we're going to actually exit out of this business services. We're only going to do in the market for SEO and SEM services. And now, as you can see, it's dropped down to 3 billion, and it kind of gives you a new estimate on your clicks and different things inside of there. The next thing that we have is your remarketing and similar audiences. So if you wanted to run a remarketing audience, this is where you could attach that, is right here. And then you can add combinations. So say that you wanted to hit people who have hit your website in the last 30 days and also are interested in SEO and SEM services. So the possibilities are not endless, but there are lots of different things that you can do inside this audience targeting. And that's why a lot of people like to run these display ads, because you can get so targeted with the audiences inside of here. So for instance, the ad group, now that I've kind of picked my my audience in here, I want to target people who are interested in SEO and SEM services. So I would put in market. And then we do SEO and SEM, and SEM services. And then that way, when I go back to this ad group, I can see that's the audience that I'm targeting inside of here. And I don't have to go through and kind of go back through the campaign to see what that is. Now, the next is you can also target by more demographics here. You can change the age, male, female, parental status, household income, all different things. And then notice, though, household income is only available for certain countries, depending on where you are watching this video from. Now, the next thing is, so these are targeting specific audiences. These, so there's audiences right here, and then there's placements. So placements you can target by keywords, topics, or specifically placements inside of here. So what that means is keywords inside of this area, it's going to be targeting blogs or different websites that have keywords that you're targeting. So if we hit in here and content targeting, and we wanted to add keywords, let's say we wanted to target blogs that are talking about SEO services, right? So that would be a way that we could also target people inside of Google. Most of the time, I will target only pretty much exclusively by these audiences. But if you wanted to experiment with keywords and topics and placements, you could do so as well. I'll kind of run through what let's look at the topics as well, so you can get an idea of what that is. And inside of here, there's just a bunch of different topics. Same thing. It's topics that are talking about these different interests, blogs or articles, websites, different things like that. And then finally, you have placements, and placements can be actually a very useful topic inside of here, because you can target specific websites, YouTube channels, YouTube videos, apps, or app categories. So let's say that you have certain websites that you know would work really well for your product or service. You can come in here and say, okay, I actually want to target XYZ. You can type it in here and see if it's available to target. Not all websites are in the Google Display Network. And so if they aren't, unfortunately, they won't show up inside of here. But you could go through and test this and find all the different websites to target your ads to specifically in this search bar. Okay, and next we have this target expansion. And most of the time, I will actually turn this off, because I have my targeting and I know who I want to hit. And I have enough impressions in here. I have almost 1 million that even with this target expansion, I think I'll still be able to hit my target audience and spend my entire budget. So if for whatever reason you have a massive budget and you need to do this target expansion, you can, but most people, I recommend turning this off. Now, and the next thing is we have this ad group bid. Google, this is where Google sometimes tries to get you to spend more money, right? Like they're recommending that advertisers, similar advertisers are paying $1.31, which I feel like Google maybe recommends a little bit too high of a bid. So I'll come in and I'll actually go lower than this. Maybe let's say 75 cents per click. And what I'll do is I'll come back the next day. And if the campaign is not getting enough impressions or clicks or things like that, then I'll raise my budget by 10 or 20% and then see what it's doing from there. If I come in and my budget's getting hit every day and I'm getting a lot of clicks, then I'll actually come through and lower the budget to maybe 65 or 50 cents, just seeing how basically cheap of clicks I can get inside of these bidding. So I wouldn't recommend going for this recommendation that they give you most of the time. You're going to want to go a little bit lower, see how it performs, then come back and see what kind of traffic you're getting. Now, the last part is we are going to create our ads. So there are a couple different ways to do this. Google really is pushing this it's somewhat new. It's been out for a couple years, but responsive display ads. This is what I recommend. This is how you're going to get the most bang for your buck. But if you wanted to, you could change here. And you could upload display ads straight onto, if you had all the different formats. So there's lots of different specs inside of here, and I can show you what those look like. So if you come in here to change, and you actually just add the URL and then choose files to upload. And here's the specs that you will need for those. Oh, wait, this isn't going to show me the specs. Sorry. Let's see. Where's the specs at? Right. Oh, supported sizes and formats. Here's all the specs that you would need if you wanted to run it this way. So this is kind of the old school way to create these banner ads. And it still can be effective if you wanted to go through and have a designer build all these ads for you. But if you wanted a quicker and easy way to just get one image or two images inside of there, then I recommend coming into, if it'll let me exit out of this, to staying in this default mode and going back to responsive display ads. And I'll show you exactly what these look like right here. So with responsive display ads, first you're going to add your final URL inside of here. And then it's going to ask you to upload as many images and logos, or two or more images and logos. And I think you can upload up to 20 inside of here. And if you're saying, oh, I don't really have a lot of images or different things, Google actually makes this really easy to complete this process. So we're going to click on here on images and logos. And what it's going to start doing is, you'll notice it's scanning my website. So it took my URL right here and it's scanning my website for all the images. And you see there's a picture of me, maybe we could run for the ad. Don't recommend it. But we have a couple of different things inside of here for PPC that we could use. And if after it scans your website, there's nothing that you like as well, Google actually has a gives you a stock library. So we could come in here and we could say digital marketing, type that in, and Google will give me a bunch of different stock images that I could use. So as you can see here, there's a bunch of different stock images, and you can type in whatever products or service you have. And don't worry about these watermarks. These will be removed when you upload the ad. So I don't want to go through and find just like the perfect image here, but what we're going to do is we're just going to click on one of these as an example. It's going to ask you for the aspect ratios that you want to use. So we're going to use both these. We're going to fit them to work, and then we're going to click on this one by one, kind of position this wherever you need it to be. And then we're going to select these two ratios to use. And you can do this for many different images as you like. Essentially, the more images you upload, the more Google will test those images and headlines inside of each other. So as you can see, we can choose up to 15 images and 5 logos to use in your ad. So as an example, I'm just going to click on this and we'll use both of these as well. I like these examples. We're going to select these two ratios, and then we are going to hit save. And what that's going to do is, you can see, it's going to add these inside of here to the rotation of the mix. And I did forget to add my logo, so I'm going to click on back over here. I'm going to go to my scan, and then we're going to add this little logo. And instead of as image, we're going to hit as logo. And we like the square, and then we're going to hit select ratio and then save that. So now we have a few different images in here and our logo. I do recommend adding as many images as you can, because like I said, it's just giving Google more ammo to create and find the best variant for your display campaign. And you can add a video inside of here for your display ads. For the purpose of this video, I'm not going to be doing that, but I do recommend, if you do have a good video, that could be used. And then the last thing is, you're going to add a few headlines in here. So for instance, if we were, you know, data driven, it pulls some different things from your website, which is nice, but you're going to want to go through and make sure that these are the right things that you want to show up for. So for instance, we could say like, get your free PPC proposal. Proposal, like as a call to action, marketing consultation. Basically, just add as many CTAs or things you can for up to 30 characters for your headlines. You can add up to 5 inside of here. So if you wanted to go through and add all those 5, and then it asks for one long tail headline. And once again, this is pulling copy from my website. So, but you're going to want to go through and change this, and we can, you know, add this headline right here. These aren't very good headlines. You're going to want to write better copy, but you kind of get the idea of what this looks like. And then a couple of descriptions, and you could add up to 5, I believe. And then the last thing you want to do is add your business name right here. So Zoco Marketing, and there we go. And what this is going to do is, it's going to show you a bunch of different options on how your ad can kind of show up, or how how this ad will basically show up. And this is kind of just the logo with the text ads. But as you come through here, you can see there are some actually really nice looking ads that are just basically created from some stock photos and using our logo and headlines. And of course, it's taking forever to load. As you see, get a free PPC proposal right here, showing up on different ad formats. And we're going to go through, and I really like this one, right? Like marketing consultation, complete guide to segments in analytics. So if you wanted to like run it to an ebook or different things to promote, you could open up that. Lots of different formats. If you wanted to see what all of the different banner ads can also look like, you can come in here to key formats. And as you can see, here is a bunch of different formats for our banner ads, which is awesome, right? So in a matter of 10 minutes, we've created a full campaign, and we've also created the display ads inside of there to run that campaign. And then the last thing is, you can look at the Google properties and check out some of how they look inside of there as well, just to give you an idea. Then the last thing we need to do is, you can come in here to additional formats, and you can leave these, I typically leave these checked, and you're gonna wanna use negative formats, leave that checked. And then URL options, you can come through and add your UTM parameters in here as well, to really track your campaigns even more thoroughly. And then more options, you can add a call to action text inside of here. So say we wanted to add this automated, or learn more different CTAs on this button inside of here. So now it's adding learn more. Or also you could customized colors. So you could actually come through and change the main colors of your ads inside of here. You'll need to have the codes to do that, but you could also just another option to customize your ads. And once you've done that, then you have successfully created your ads. You just need to hit come in here to create campaign. And then we're going to wait for this to load up. Or is it giving me create campaign? I need to add, because I was playing around with these keywords. So we need to delete this audience that we have here. Forgot that I added this. So we're going to delete this. We only want to run this top audience up here, which is SEO and SEM services. So now we're going to come back because it's telling me you need to choose one of these options. Now we're going to come back and hit create campaign. I'm like, what's the error that we're getting there? And then that's going to load up and we are going to say, oh, congratulations, you have created your campaign and it is ready. So congratulations, your campaign is created if you follow along in there. But we are not done. I want to just go through and show you some of the options that you can do to edit your campaigns after they've been built. Some other things that you can do to really optimize them and take them to the next level. And here we are. So I actually decided that I wanted to run this campaign for a couple of days just so that I could show you real data inside of the account. So as you can see, this campaign ran for 2 days and we got 35 clicks and 52 clicks here. And we spent a total of $55.55, average cost per click of 64 cents, click-through rate and impressions and clicks. And so I wanted to do this so that I could show you real practical data that, and how I would analyze this data to make optimizations and different things like that. So we're gonna jump right into this. As you see, we didn't get any conversions. Obviously the point of this wasn't really to get conversions. It was more to just bring in data, show you those things. The first thing that I do after a display campaign has been running is I will come down and I'll actually look in this more settings and I'll come down here to the ad schedule and I'll see what time of day my ads actually ran. And as we come here to the hour, you'll see that most of my budget got spent between 12 a.m. and 1 a.m., which means Google just started spending the money basically the day that it could and it spent all of that money. And now what that tells me is that I can probably lower my average CPC and still get the same amount of clicks and traffic possible. And also it might be helpful for me to set up an ad schedule where I'm excluding those kind of early morning times where I know people probably won't be converting for these different things. So the first thing that I would do is I would come over here to this ad schedule and you could come in and you can edit this and say, okay, I want to show all days, but I only want to show all days between maybe like 6 or 5 a.m. to let's say, like 9 p.m., right? That way I'm not getting these really strange hours and my budget's just getting spent all in the first hour of the day between 1 and 12 a.m. like it was in this situation. So I'd come through and save that. And then now we're only going to be showing our ads between these hours. This is something that you could set up before you start running your campaign. I do recommend if you kind of have an idea of where people might convert, you can go through and do that. The next thing is, since I mentioned, I think we spent our budget really quickly. And so I think it's safe to say that we could come through and lower our average cost per click. So I'm going to come back to this ad group and we have it at 75 cents. So I'm actually going to go through and I would decrease this all the way down to maybe 45 cents and see if I still get the same amount of traffic. Just because I blew through that budget so quick, I think I could get basically double the clicks for the same amount of money by lowering this average CPC. So that's another thing that I would do. And then the final thing that is the most important, and this is something that you might want to do before you start running your campaign as well, but that is to add negative placements or check out where your ads are showing actually on the Google Display Network. So that would be coming down here to this placements tab. And you can click on this where my ads are showing. And as you can see here, as we look at where we actually spent money, you can see that majority of my spend went to these mobile apps. And most of the time, these mobile apps are going to be money wasters, right? They're not going to be high converting sites. They're going to show up on these pop-ups where people accidentally click them or random things. Like as you can see here, I have a 14% click-through rate, which is, it may seem awesome that it's a high click-through rate, but what that probably means is people are accidentally or clicking on those ads or being almost tricked into clicking on those ads. So typically when you have really high click-through rates like that, it's kind of a little bit of a red flag. Because how often do you really click on display ads? So I do recommend going through these and say that I didn't want to show up on this mobile app. You come through and hit and then edit and then exclude from campaign. So you could exclude that mobile app specifically from your campaign. Now you may be telling yourself, well, this is a tedious process and it's going to take forever to go through all of these. And I do agree. And that is why I have a solution for you. So stick around just for a second. I'm gonna show you my kind of high level solution for this, but I do want to give you an example. Like here's a website right here. And I'm like, okay, I spent, you know, 68 cents on this site, but is it a good site? So if we actually come through and we click and we copy this paste and put this URL in here and we go to pauseplanet.me, we can look at what this site actually looks like. And obviously be careful when you do this because you can get some pretty sketchy sites. And when we come in here, you can see that there's like recent posts. It's kind of like a very clickbaity titles. Not something that I would really want my brand to be associated with, and probably a lot of people that are just accidentally clicking places. So I would go through and I would actually exclude that. So I would click on here and then do the same thing. I would exclude that from ad group. So I do recommend when you're spending a lot of money, if coming through this where your ads actually show up and saying, okay, I don't want to be on that site or I don't want to be on this one, and kind of just do a quick overview of that. But if you want to take some of the work that I've done over the past five years and compile that all into one so that you're not showing up on any of crappy placements that I've on the, all the accounts that I've worked on, I actually created this list right here. It's a massive list of negative placements for both. Sorry, this thing is in the way. Let's collapse this. It has display placement exclusions, and there are over like 30,000 on this list. And then also has mobile app placement exclusions. And if you are doing YouTube stuff, you can also do YouTube channel exclusions. And what this is a list of crappy mobile websites, crappy mobile apps, and crappy websites that I've identified over the past years, and in compiling different lists and putting them together. And this is going to be 100% free down in the link below. Go through and click this. And what you'll want to do with this list is come through, and I'm not going to copy the whole thing because it will probably freeze with the camera running in Excel, but basically take, you know, I'm only going to grab a few here, but you're going to want to grab the whole list, copy this, actually first file and then make a copy for yourself. This is where you have it, but then come through here and copy. Oops, I just hit Command V, Command C, and then come over to this. And then you're going to go to exclusions. And then you're going to come through here. You're going to hit this little blue pencil. You're going to hit exclusion placements. And then you want to, let's hide this. You're going to want to enter multiple placements right here and then just come through and copy that list. I think it will only let you do like 10,000 at a time. So grab 10,000 or whatever that may be. And then you're going to make sure you hit this add 13 placements here. And then you are going to save that. So that's for the website. You can go through and add those four sites. And then you're going to want to come through and do the same thing for mobile apps. So we just did that for the display placements. Then we're going to come to mobile app exclusions. And then we're going to grab, you know, for you, you're going to want to grab more than 13, grab all of them. And essentially come in here to back to placements, grab the little pencil again, exclude placements. And then this time we want to enter multiple placements and hit that right there. Add these 14 placements. And one placement wasn't added. Maybe it's like the wrong format or something, which is totally fine. So, but if you wanted to be excluded from apps completely, or you didn't want to show up on apps, what you could do is you could come here to apps. You could come into app categories and then basically just exclude all of these categories. And that's like a kind of a quicker way to just be like, I don't want to show up in mobile apps. I can go through and just essentially click on all of these and say, no, I don't want to show up in any of these categories. Save that. And then now you won't be showing on majority of apps, but still keep an eye on those different things. So once again, that list is down below, 100% free. All I ask for is if you aren't subscribed, please subscribe or like the video. And that's pretty much everything that I have to go over today. I hope you enjoyed the real data and me actually running a campaign and showing kind of the real time things that you could do inside of there. And we will see you in the next video.